about the magnetic fields around younger versions of stars just like our own sun. A little bit of background knowledge. These are called T-Tauri variables, and one of their key features is that they have large disks of gas and dust around them. And we really want to understand how these disks move, because they eventually form into things like planets. And for obvious reasons, we're interested in planets and how they form. We live on one, so you know, it's good to understand your home. But the movements of these disks are governed by magnetic fields. So until we understand the magnetic fields, we can't fully understand planet formation. And my job is to go about finding out about those magnetic fields. So how do we do this? Well, first you gotta get some data. I'm using data from two different places, McDonald Observatory in West Texas, and the VLT, Very Large Telescope, in Chile. This is just, I got to go out there this spring and drive one of the telescopes. It was really cool, so that was fun. But once you have your data, what do you do with it? Well, if you look at the light that's produced at every color that a star produces, you'll notice that there's these dips in certain places. We call those spectral lines. If you're looking at this red line here, each of these dips, whoop, that's a spectral line. And the thing is, these can vary both in how deep they are and in how wide they are. And that actually encodes a lot of information about the star. In particular, spectral lines can be widened for two main reasons. There's other ones, but these are the biggest ones. First of all, there can be a magnetic field, which due to quantum effects causes the line to get broader. And also, the star can be rotating, and the faster it rotates, the broader that line will look. Well, this is great news. Now we have a method to go about measuring these magnetic fields. The only problem is, how do we tell these two causes apart? Well, fortunately, different elements are sensitive to different types of broadening. So for example, something like titanium is sensitive to both the magnetic fields and to the rotation of the star. And so it will be kind of doubly broadened. Whereas something like carbon monoxide is not magnetically sensitive, so it will only be broadened by the rotation. So you can see where we have only rotation, we've got a very narrow line, and where we have both magnetic fields and rotation, we have a much broader line. So by comparing these two lines within the same star, we can say this much broadening is due to rotation, and so we can figure out the rotation of the star, and this much leftover broadening has to be due to the magnetic fields, and we can back out the magnetic fields there. So what do I actually do all day? Well, mostly I sit at a computer. I spend a lot of time cleaning data, so this is how the data looks when I get it, this is how it looks when I'm done, it's much prettier. And then once I have my nice clean data, I use a stellar model that was developed by my professor, and I fit this to the star. And the model has encoded in it parameters about how fast the star rotates, and all sorts of other parameters about the star. Once it's fitted, I have magical numbers telling me how fast that star rotates and also how strong its magnetic fields are. And then we can take these numbers and go back to the theory and back to the other work that people have done in other scientific papers and say, how are we doing? So these green bars here are numbers that other scientists have gotten through different methods of looking at these stars. And these yellow bars are ones that I've gotten for different stars. And you see, they line up really, really well. And that's really good news, because it means that we're probably on the right track. It means that our models are good, it means that our methodology is sound, and we're ready to move forward and answer more bigger questions. So what do those look like? Well, we definitely want to start measuring more types of stars. Stellar evolution varies a lot depending on how big your star is. We want to understand that. We also want to see if we can get at the shape of the magnetic field in addition to just how strong it is. And finally, we want to take this and apply it to planet formation models so we can understand how places like our own Earth come into existence. Thank you so much for your time.